not be forgotten when they are hounded by those preaching hate, that the nation will rally behind their icons of the future as they may have been in the past. Here's what happened before we debate what must happen next.
The portrayal of young Geeta Fogut forced India to sit up and take notice. A Kashmiri girl playing a wrestler from Haryana's heartland with such brilliance that it left the audience in awe. While the nation was busy celebrating this new acting talent, Zaira herself was being terrorized, being forced to issue an apology saying that she's not a role model, something that has outraged India.
पूरे वर्ल्ड को जारा पे प्राउड है और हमें भी प्राउड है, हम भी जारा के साथ में, जो इस तरह के लोग किसी को कुछ भी उठा के बोल देते हैं, बस बोलने तक ही मतलब होता है, तो उनके लिए जरूर कोई सख्त कानून बनना चाहिए। जारा आपके किसी भी चीज का प्रेशर ला लें, और दुनिया का काम है बोलना और हमारा काम है करना, आप ऐसे ही अपना काम करते रहिए, दुनिया जो चाहे बोले, और न ही आपको कोई माफी मांगने की जरूरत है।
And I think the war is against that mindset which prevails in India and in Jammu and Kashmir. There are many who came for intolerance debate and they are keeping silence, so they must go.
The state and the center too are visibly upset.
These pseudo-liberals, they are always violent on nationalist issues. On such issues, they are silent. This speaks about their double standards.
उसको अप्रिशिएट करना चाहिए, लेकिन जिस प्रकार से उसको थ्रेट्स आ रही थी, ये बहुत अनफॉर्चुनेट है। ये उन लोगों का माइंडसेट बताता है कि किस प्रकार से डेमोक्रेसी के ऊपर वो जमहूरियत पे बिल्कुल विश्वास नहीं करते।
देश सरकार की ओर से हमें ये जानकारी प्राप्त हुई है कि वो सारे घटनाक्रम पर नजर रखे हुए और जो भी उचित कार्रवाई होगी वो करेंगे। यदि कहीं सुरक्षा का विषय होगा तो वो सुरक्षा भी उपलब्ध करवाएंगे, मुहैया करवाएंगे।
इवन द टॉलरेंस ब्रिगेड जॉइंड द आजादी फ्रॉम टेरर कोरस।
आमिर खान जी ने जो कहा वो बिल्कुल सही कहा, और हम सभी उनके साथ हैं, तो उसे डरने की और घबराने की कोई जरूरत नहीं।
The anti-India League has been stung again. They have tried every trick in the book to terrorize young minds, but failed again and again. From arming kids with stones to forcing youth to pick up guns, every threat to the idea of India has fallen flat. But can we ensure freedom from this terror for once and for all? Your report, NewsX.
All right, let's open up the conversation tonight. On the broadcast with me, Geeta Fogut and Babita joining us live. It's their life stories that this entire film Dangal was based on which, of course, the young protagonist of the young wrestler was played by young Zaira. Air Marshal Kapil Kak is with me in the studio. Shivani Wazir Pasri joining us in a bit. Major General G.D. Bakshi joining us also. Sharvishtha Mukherjee, representing the Congress tonight, China NC with the BJP, and Nisha Jamwal is also joining us from Bombay. Geeta, let me begin with you. जब आपको कल खबर आई that Zaira के साथ ऐसे हुआ था, आपको कैसा लगा?
बहुत बुरा लगा और दुख हुआ कि लोग अभी भी ऐसी मानसिकता रखते हैं, क्योंकि
गीता जी ये मानसिकता की बात कर रही है, ये मानसिकता ये जो लोग रख रहे हैं वो भारत के खिलाफ भी मानसिकता रखते हैं। आपको खुशी हुई कि भारतवासी आमिर खान, आप जैसे लोग सब इकट्ठे आज उठकर बात कर रहे हैं?
जी बिल्कुल, अच्छा लग रहा है कि आज जायरा के साथ पूरा देश खड़ा है, और कुछ लोगों के लिए, सिर्फ वो चंद ही लोग हैं जो किसी की सक्सेस होता है उसको देख नहीं सकते। कोई बढ़ता हुआ लड़की है या फिर कोई भी इंसान जो एक मेहनत करके कुछ अचीव करना चाहता है, उसके कदम रोकना चाहते हैं, तो उन कुछ चंद लोगों की वजह से हम इतने दुखी होते हैं कि हमें आज एक पैनल में हम बैठे हैं और उसके उस मुद्दे पर हम बात कर रहे हैं। तो एक बहुत ही शर्मनाक बात है कि आज भी लोग इस तरह की मानसिकता रखते हैं, क्योंकि मुझे पता है कि आज जो जिस समय से आज जायरा गुजर रही है, वो समय आज से 15 साल पहले उस समय से हम भी गुजरे हैं, और उस समय सिर्फ हमारे पिता का साथ हमारे साथ था, और आज जायरा के साथ तो पूरा हिंदुस्तान खड़ा है।
ओके बबीता, एक एक भारतीय, एक रेसलर, एक अचीवर, एक आइकॉन और एक 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 औरत के नाते आप जायरा को आज रात को क्या बोलना चाहेंगे?
जी, मैं जायरा को यही बोलना चाहूंगी कि जायरा, आपको डरने की जरूरत नहीं है, न ही आपको कोई माफी मांगने की जरूरत है, क्योंकि आपके साथ पूरा देश खड़ा है, पूरे देश को आप पे गर्व है और हमें भी आप पे गर्व है। और उनके पेरेंट्स को कहना चाहूंगी कि आप अपनी बच्ची के साथ खड़े रहिए, कोई पूरी दुनिया की ताकत उनको आगे बढ़ने से नहीं रोक सकती अगर आप उनके साथ हैं और पूरा देश उनके साथ है।
ओके, लेट मी ओपन अप दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन। चाइना एनसी ऑफ द बीजेपी आल्सो जॉइनिंग अस ऑन द ब्रॉडकास्ट। लेट मी गो टू कपिल काक फर्स्ट। आई एम मार्शल काक, द पीपल हु वर डूइंग दिस आर द सेम पीपल हु हैव बीन, वन वुड प्रिज्यूम, होल्डिंग ऑन टू अ माइंडसेट ऑफ द पास्ट। There have been mystery forces who have been burning down schools in the valley. There have been mystery forces who have been plotting terror attacks at employment buildings. There have been mystery forces who have been accused of forcing young children to stone pelt. There is a direct assault on the future, the youth of Kashmir. Now, what do we say to these forces tonight?
No, it's not a binary, Rishabh. I'd like to suggest we look at the issue very sensitively and in a very total kind of a basis. Number one, without doubt, asking Zaira to apologize is reprehensible, to say the least. That there are two sentiments running in India and sentiments running in the state of Jammu and Kashmir of India also needs to be recognized, because there is anger, there is alienation. 6 months long period has caused a whole lot of trauma, including stress disorders, primarily because political issues are not being addressed through dialogue and stakeholder conversation. That's one sentiment. What happens that this sentiment tends to overwhelm and trump the other sentiments, which are also coincident? For example, Parvez Rasool, cricketer. There are Bollywood actors who are Kashmiris. Zaira is an achiever. We had Taijul Islam, who was an 8-year-old girl, won the gold in kickboxing. Another boy who's about the same age in boxing. You see, there are the main point for us in the rest of India is to appreciate there are two currents running. And our aim must be, just let me finish. Our aim must be to ensure that Kashmiri sentiment remains stable, tranquil, and Kashmiris genuinely integrate with India and in a manner in which
here it is, a girl who's been brought up in Srinagar comes, gets an opportunity, she's wowed the nation, sir, and she's been hounded as soon as she got back home. Shouldn't there be a word of criticism for those who are doing it, and for those who burn the schools, and those who come from that mindset?
No, we must not conflate the
but
two.
But it's the youth of Kashmir, sir.
No, I just need to make a point, and after that you can cross-question me again. My point is, it is absolutely deplorable that a person who has excelled in this is being asked to apologize merely because, quote-unquote, she has done an active role which is un-Islamic. I mean, this is most reprehensible.
It's more than reprehensible.
Because Bollywood has been shaped by people, icons, Dilip Kumar, Mehboob Khan. Look at Naushad, the music producer. Look at the three Khans today. I mean, it's amazing how Bollywood has been shaped.
Okay,
I
want to take heart. China NC, should we take heart today? Because the person whom very few in your party would like and would certainly remember for having once suggested that he and his wife had mooted leaving this country has today spoken out for this girl. There has been near unanimity, China NC, in criticizing the reprehensible, as Air Marshal Kark says, antics of what we've seen in the past 24 hours. Should we take heart from that?
So has the entire nation. Why are you raising this question? This is not about an individual's opinion. You ask any woman in this country today and they'll say that Zaira is the pride of Jammu and Kashmir. The chief minister of Jammu and Kashmir has applauded her. And there you have some retards in terms of separatists who choose to have their own reason to condemn her and talk in this unparliamentary language about her and her choice unparliamentary language about her and her choice of dress, etc., which is so regressive. So if you ask me honestly, this is a young 16-year-old beautiful girl who has played an extraordinary role, inspired by these real-life heroes who are called Geeta and Babita. And I think that the fact that we are thinking out of the box shows that the country is ready to explore. The artists are willing to explore. So for those people who choose to have this myopic mindset and they only want to get into controversy and show how they can bully, times are changing and it's time they realize.
So I'm hoping the times are changing, Shaina NC. How do we make sure they keep changing? How do we make sure that what we've seen today, doesn't go back to the appeasement tomorrow, doesn't go back to the soft peddling tomorrow?
Rishabh, the fact that we're debating about a story such as this is one step in the right direction. Outrage is a must, especially when you have a handful of people who choose to be so-called moral guardians and believe in their religious ideology and expect every woman in the 21st century to adhere to it. What rubbish! Gone are those days. Look at the way civil society has stood up for Zaira. Look at the kind of trolling that happened, and look at the kind of support this young girl
has
got. Okay,
I'll pick up from that point. I want to invite Sharmishtha Mukherjee and Nisha Jambal into the conversation. Shivani Pasrij is also joining us. Nisha Jambal, let me begin with you. Before I go to Ms. Mukherjee, Nisha Jambal, we take heart, of course, that the unanimity of opinion has spoken out, but is it enough, Nisha Jambal? Is it in practical terms going to help this girl who's fearing for her safety?
We have to keep in mind that she's 16-year-old. She issued that apology. She was intimidated. But hats off to people like Amir who came out in support of her and the whole nation. I belong to Jammu. So I definitely think she's a role model for not only Jammu and Kashmir, but for the whole country. She's played a role which is not an easy role to play. It's a feminist role where, I mean, it epitomizes the fact that women have to move forward. So it's a big step for the country, but it's also very heartening for somebody like me to see that the whole country has stood up in support for her. I think we are moving in the right direction.
Okay, we're moving in the right direction, but where does it go next? Okay, Sharmishtha Mukherjee, again, if you're happy to say, and I want to paint a rosy picture, that we're moving the right direction, there is always a danger that it falls back to the same appeasement, same soft peddling tomorrow, and perhaps the kind words that have come her way are not enough tonight.
Rishabh, there are two, three issues involved in this. One is definitely the political issue and the religious issue. Another is plain and simple trolling. You know, let us understand one thing very clearly, that trolls are, they do not adhere to any ideology, they do not adhere to any religion, they do not adhere to anything. You know, trolls are trolls, period. And I'm sure everybody out here, probably including yourself, also has been trolled. So one thing we have to understand that, you know, in instances like this, you know, the whole India has come together with this young, courageous girl, and I really kind of empathize with her that, you know, a poor 16-year-old girl, forget about the fact that she is a celebrity, forget about the fact, but just the sheer fact that, you know, what she has to go through. So what can we do to stop this?
No, tell us.
One thing is extremely important to have very, very strong and easily implementable cyber laws.
You know, it's not just about cyber laws. Let's not restrict ourselves, Sharmishtha Mukherjee. This is about hate. This is about people who don't want the youth in Kashmir to have an icon. Who are trying to cut down that icon through hate and through fear. How do we cut them back, Sharmishtha Mukherjee?
From laws. So similarly, when we are talking about cyber crime or any kind of hate crime, we have to have strong laws. It's absolutely imperative. There is
okay,
no contradiction.
Is that it? Is that it? Shivani Pasrij, you've seen what's happened, both the obnoxious incident that has taken place to try to intimidate a young girl who stood out for her achievement, as well as the reaction that have come in, Shivani Pasrij. What do we take away from this?
You know, I've grown up, we are from Srinagar, and I've spent many summer holidays walking the streets of Sonwar. As children, my sister, cousins and I, we'd walk down, giggle, do little shopping on the streets. So I can very well imagine the kind of background that this young lady's grown up in. And then she spent 6 months training intensely, and those kind of physical acrobatics that were done, it's not easy. So she's a young girl. Today, young people have many distractions. She stayed focused. She's worked really hard. Physically, she's fitted the role. Mentally, she's done a brilliant job of acting. And she looks so stunning that even with the simplicity, you cannot help but absolutely adore and admire her. I want to find one person who saw that film and didn't hold their breath and wait for her to achieve her success. So if people are condemning this, then I think it's very good in a way, because other people who are aspiring to excel can see how inane the condemnation is. And they can say, okay, if she had to fight it, we have to fight it too.
Okay, let me clasp
because
the point.
Because gone are the days when you can afford to be put down by some
let
people.
Let me clasp the point. G.D. Bakshi joining us on the broadcast. G.D. Bakshi, this is the moment. This is the moment that the icons for young Kashmiris are not trammeled, and the people who are hanging on to a mindset of hate know that. They know that a time has come and they're fighting against the tide. How do we fight back, G.D. Bakshi, to ensure that those who burn the schools, who threaten the icons of the youth, get told back? G.D. Bakshi, you can hear us.
I would like to say,
yeah, go ahead, sir.
This young girl, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead, sir.
You know, I would like to state unequivocally that this young girl has acted in an iconic movie, in an iconic role that promotes female empowerment, not only in India, not only in Kashmir, across the world. It gives the people, the girls, an ideal to live up to, an ideal of self-assertion, an ideal that you can do what you want, that you can go out and conquer the world. And, you know, for this poor girl to be set upon like this, because she has participated in an excellent artistic at a message that is universal. I would not even say, you know, it just touches the whole nation, but like Malala's message, it reaches out to the whole world. Our girls can do what they want. They can achieve what they want. What is so wrong with that? Why should she be trolled? Why should she be tried to be, you know, forced into submission?
Yeah,
and
who
silence?
Has the most to fear from this? That's the point, G.D. Bakshi. Just stay with me, because two of
these
those fine women are sitting with us tonight. Two of the fine women, Geeta and Babita Fogat, sitting with us tonight. They'll be listening into this conversation. Let me go quickly back to them. Geeta, फिल्मिंग के दौरान, ट्रेनिंग के दौरान, जब आप जायरा से मिले, आपका उनसे इंटरेक्शन क्या हुआ, आप उनसे बातचीत करने की कैसे लगा आपको?
मैं सबसे पहले मैं बताऊंगी कि मैं जायरा से, जब दंगल फिल्म की शूटिंग का फर्स्ट डे था, मैं उस दिन जायरा से मिली थी. और जायरा ने खुद बताया जिस दिन वो मिली कि वो बहुत ही एक्साइटेड थी हमसे मिलने के लिए. वो बहुत ही इंस्पायर हुई हमसे, मेरे परिवार से, हम बहनों से. और मैं जायरा के बारे में ये भी बताना चाहूंगी कि जायरा ने इस फिल्म से पहले कभी कोई स्पोर्ट्स ही नहीं किया, और जायरा ने इतनी मेहनत की है इस रोल के लिए कि जो मुझे लगता है कि कोई और लड़की नहीं कर सकती थी. और जो मेरे रोल में, अगर छोटी गीता के रोल में मैं कहूँ, तो जायरा से बेहतर ना जायरा की जितनी कोई मेहनत कर सकता है, और ना ही कोई ऐसा किरदार कर सकता था.
ओके.
और मुझे बहुत दुख हुआ जब जायरा का स्टेटस पढ़ा, जब सुना कि जायरा बहुत दुखी है, तो मुझे मेरा वो 15 साल पहले जब हम बचपन में थे, तो हमारे वो दिन याद मुझे आ गए कि हम भी मतलब इस स्थिति से निकले हैं, और ये सब चीजें हमारे साथ भी हुई हैं, और
okay,
वो चीज आज 15 साल
की
बाद फिर हुई हैं. तो बहुत
पीपल डोंट बिलीव इन यू. लेट मी गेट बबिता इनटू दिस. बबिता, आपने पूरी जिंदगी अपनी ट्रेनिंग करी है, डिसिप्लिन दिखाया है, उसका उसको दिखाने के लिए ऑन स्क्रीन कुछ क्षण भी जो जितनी ट्रेनिंग करनी पड़ी जायरा को 6 महीने में, वो कितनी मुश्किल थी?
ज्यादा मुश्किल थी क्योंकि 6 महीने उन्होंने ट्रेनिंग की है और उस लेवल की ट्रेनिंग दिखाना कि जिस लेवल पे हम नेशनल लेवल पे इतने साल करके पहुंचे हैं, तो आप मूवी देख के ही पता लगता है कि उस लड़की ने कितनी मेहनत की, क्योंकि रेसलिंग एक ऐसा गेम है कि आप 6 महीने में मैट पे भी खड़े होकर नहीं दिखा सकते, और उसने उस लेवल की रेसलिंग करके दिखाई है जिस इंटरनेशनल लेवल पे, तो ये बहुत ही गर्व की और बहुत ही
showing their classmates, their seniors, that what all can be achieved. How important is that?
I think it's one of the most important things right now. It's the need of the hour, especially in my state of Jammu and Kashmir, where we need icons like this, where we need people to show us, young girls, especially a girl of 16, to show the youth of Jammu and Kashmir that they have a future, despite all the challenges they face. Despite day-to-day challenges, they can come out and make such successes of themselves. I actually feel sad about what's happened, this trolling thing, because you look at the fact that here you have a heroic woman and everyone should be lauding her for her work, just like Babita and Geeta just said. Why are we pulling them down? Why does this nation, that's why we lost our country to the Brits. I think the time has come for everyone to join hands and laud our heroes, to put them out there like icons and...
Yeah, and to stand up against those who don't want to, who don't want us to, because they have something to fear. And GD Bakshi, what is it that these people have to fear? That they don't want the stories of Geeta and Babita told by a young girl from Kashmir.
Can I make a point? What
these I'm coming straight back to you, ma'am, after this. GD Bakshi.
What they have to fear, is the rise of local icons to the national stature. The boy who topped the IAS is such an icon. This girl is almost a Kashmiri version of Malalai, who fought for girl empowerment, who symbolized, who epitomized women empowerment. So these people are on their way to becoming symbols, not just at the national level, but I would say even at the global level.
And
they
that's
have
the point.
The potential
okay, let's go
to
across.
Go up to the global level to
And
to
that's the point. So who's trying to put down the symbols?
That is what they don't like. They would like to keep it to a ghetto. Kashmir to a ghetto
okay,
of extremism. Where the women are put behind chadors, their schools are burned, they are not allowed to come out, leave alone trying to break free of the shackles of intimidation and slavery which have been there for thousands of years.
Okay, sir, hang on. Finance.
Rishabh, I don't think this story is just about Jammu and Kashmir or just about Zaira. This is about women in the 21st century. Now, there's so many young girls who are thinking out of the box, who are playing sports which are out of the box. Whoever thought that there would be this kind of an opportunity for them, real life stories which are epitomized by so many. On the other hand, you have this handful of separatists who would do anything to be noticed. And the easiest thing to do is to troll or to condemn or to, cast
but
a fatwa or to come out and say that,
this people, China. Why?
Act was
That's
wrong
the
or this dress was wrong or this doing was wrong. I think the time has come, whether it's a Khap Panchayat or whether it's a separatist, whether it is a religious leader who under the garb of playing moral police is choosing to determine...
Okay, I'm running short of time. I'm going
to
take reactions across the board.
Condemned in
Sharmishtha Mukherjee,
so happy
the people who want to intimidate and scare,
direction.
because they are scared themselves of the icons that are arising. What do we tell them tonight?
I mean, we just have to tell them, you know, giving them the example of Zaira, that, and we should have to tell Zaira, I do tell Zaira, and on behalf of, I'm sure, everybody, all our audience, we tell Zaira, Zaira, please go ahead and do your work. We are with you, the whole India is with you. Don't feel scared, don't get intimidated. We are all with you, we are proud of you, and we will do whatever to support you, to protect you.
Okay, Amashanka.
No, I think I'm totally with the current. Zaira needs to be admired. She is an iconic figure. On that, there is no question. It also needs to be put on the table that these achievements and excellence have been initiated in an environment in which they have faced so much suffering and pain, and there is so much tumult and unrest. That is the admirable thing. It's not in a stable environment. But I think we need to understand that this trolling, there are no separatist leaders who have actually condemned Zaira. It's the trolling that has happened. Cyber laws are required. I mean, Facebook have gone on record to say that they are initiating measures by which hate crimes on cyber will be filtered out at various stages. But a larger question, Rishabh, I'd like you to bear with me. The larger question is, this is a cross-sectoral retaliation by the sentiment which is very anti-India, which is youth who are hugely alienated, and because there is no political process moving forward in terms of dialogue, they tend to actually distort art, culture, and sports, which should be delineated.
I don't want to skirt away.
This is an important point. If we are all rising for Zaira, we also need to rise in support of a dialogue, political dialogue, with the stakeholders, and get to stabilize Kashmir. It's important.
Those people within Kashmir who don't want the youths to have their own icons. Giri Bakshi, last 30 seconds, sir. I'm going to leave the last word with Geeta and Babita.
You know, like I said, that there are some children from Kashmir who, despite the turmoil, despite the attempts to intimidate and, you know, instigate violence, have risen above the tumult. Their voices are heard at the national level, who topped the IAS exam. There is this girl who was taken on such a dare that, and that epitomizes.
Okay, sir, I'm sorry, I'm losing your line. I'm losing your line. There's a bit of a disturbance and we're running short of time. I'm going to leave the last word with Geeta and Babita. Geeta, aap shuruaat mein humse keh rahi thi that jo Zaira ke saath pichle 24 ghante mein hua hai, aapko yaad aayi jab aap 15-16 saal ki thi aur aapko bhi aisi mushkilon se jo log aapko kuchalne ki koshish kar rahe the unse jhagad kar apne aap ko khud upar lana pada tha. Zaira jo ab ye इसी कोशिश में जुझ गई है, उसको क्या बोलना चाहेंगे आप?
मैं जायरा को यही कहना चाहती हूँ कि जायरा, हम भी इन सब चीजों से निकल के हम इस मुकाम तक पहुंचे हैं, और हमारे साथ तो किसी का सपोर्ट भी नहीं था, जबकि जायरा के साथ तो हम खड़े हैं, पूरा देश खड़ा है. तो जायरा को डरने की, घबराने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. जायरा जो कर रही है उससे, उस पर हमें प्राउड है, देश को प्राउड है, और जायरा इसी के साथ आगे बढ़ती रहे और मेहनत करे और सफलता हासिल करे.
ओके, वी आर प्राउड ऑफ यू, एंड दैट्स वन सिंगल मैसेज वी कैन टेक आउट विदाउट डिस्प्यूट फ्रॉम हियर. लेट दैट बी इट. द टू लेडीज हु आर ऑफ कोर्स पिक्चराइज्ड इन दैट फिल्म आर सिटिंग विद अस टुनाइट. थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस एंड पुटिंग योर पॉइंट्स अक्रॉस. होपफुली दे हैव बीन हर्ड राइट अक्रॉस द लेंथ एंड ब्रेथ ऑफ इंडिया. लेट मी डू अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक. ऑन द अदर साइड, we examine the developments in Tamil Nadu that have led to another